3 investigations are underway into the fatal train crash in Melbourne, which claimed the life of a passenger and left several others injured.
The level crossing where the truck and train collided is a prime focus for investigators. Let's cross to our reporter Jade Vincent, who's at the scene for us tonight. Jade, what's been happening today?
Tash, it's been a long and hard day for crews here working through the rubble. The ground is boggy and the sheer size of the wreckage is making it all the more difficult as they try to investigate and clear the mess at the same time. Now, out of all 30 passengers on board, only 2 remain in hospital. The train driver is in a serious but stable condition and a 59-year-old woman is also stable. Now, despite one man's tragic death, crews here are shaking their heads that so many were able to walk away.
Heavy haulage equipment was needed to remove the smashed carriages, which were tossed around the tracks by the impact. The train wreck damage was widespread as tracks were shredded. The rear carriages of the train were towed away as workers carved an access road to clear the carnage.
Because of the difficult environment, it's going to take us probably a couple of days maybe to fully clear what we need to.
It was business as usual for nearby sheet metal worker Paul Sorensen, who ran to the smash to help passengers.
I was just thinking there's going to be dead people everywhere and... Yeah.
Police combed the scene by floodlight throughout the night. They had the difficult task of searching for anyone who may have been trapped. But just before 4 a.m, some relief.
And we've been able to satisfy ourselves that there were no other victims in or around the train.
In daylight, the search for clues stepped up with 3 separate investigations into this tragedy underway. Early signs show there was nothing wrong with the rail line or crossing.
It looks as though the boom gates were in the down position, so the lights from witnesses were flashing.
The tragedy reigniting the call to remove dangerous level crossings.
Although it's rare that this kind of freak occurrence would occur, we need to look at preventative measures.
There is no question many decades of backlog.
Police have interviewed the 69-year-old truck driver. He's been released pending further inquiries, while the 30-year-old train driver remains in a serious but stable condition in hospital. Services will be affected along this line for at least the next 5 days, but rail operators say commuters won't be affected on one of Melbourne's busiest days on public transport. But for all involved, it was a day they will never forget.
People were just walking away from it as well, and I was like, how can you walk away from this?
Now, Victoria is unique in that we have so many level crossings, in fact, 177 across suburban areas. This particular level crossing is due for an upgrade, but is placed 144th on the list. Now, in the meantime, inquiries into this crash will be running for quite some time.
Jade, thank you.